Hi, and welcome to a new video of this MOOC. In this video, we are going to develop our first Angular application, a classic Hello World application. But before, we need to set up our computer to install Angular in it, okay? The requirement is just to have installed Node.js and NPM in our computer. And for doing this, I recommend you to go to the official web page, to the official documentation of Node.js, and to follow there the specific steps defined for your operating system. Depending on if you are using Mac, Ubuntu, Windows, etc., the instructions will be different. So go there and follow the defined steps. Then, when we already have Node.js and NPM installed, we can install or we have to install Angular technology using this simple command, npm install angular CLI. Okay, this will install the command line interface tool of Angular that will allow us to start working with it. If we use the option G, this will globally install the component or the technology in our computer. Okay, I recommend you to include this. Once it is installed, we can run this command ng help to check that Angular has been correctly installed, and with this command Angular lists a set of commands we can execute to start working with it. So now we can create our first application. Just type in the shell this basic command ng new and the name of the project we are going to create. Okay, this will execute a set of orders. We will see now an example, and Angular generates a new folder with the same name of the project in which we can enter and execute this command for starting the server, okay, the application, the sample application Angular creates for us, ng serve. If we use the O action, Angular will also open a web browser and navigates to this URL in which the Angular application is running, okay? This is important to take into account that Angular also uses a mechanism to automatically watch the files included in the project. So every time we modify and save a file included in the project, Angular will rebuild and relaunch the application. This is really nice, and this is very, very useful. Once we have this sample application started, we are going to modify just a few things in order to take a look to the main parts that have been created by Angular in this sample application. Okay, we will change the message that is displayed in the application in the main page, and we also include a CSS class to modify the style of the text that is displayed in the application. When Angular has created this first application for us, it has also created a first component that is called application component. So we will see that these three files corresponding to the component has been created. We will modify these files in order to start learning Angular. Okay, we will see the template of the component, this example page of Angular, in which we can see how Angular will display a simple message, welcome to, and with these brackets, Angular renders the value of the title property that is defined in the logic of the component. Okay, if we go to application component .ts, we can see the logic of the component, and we can see a property that is called title, and that is automatically rendered in this template. Okay, so let's code. Let's see this with detail. I'm going to open a a shell script terminal in which I'm going to create my first application with this ngu new hello world application, okay? As you can see, now Angular will start creating the set of files that are needed to start with this application. By now, the only files that are interesting for us are the related with the component, as the main component that is created in the application. And as you can remember, there are three important files that are the one for defining the CSS styles, the one for defining the template, that is the view is going to be rendered to the user in the web page, and finally the one in which we implement the logic of the component, okay? That is this file with the TypeScript extension, okay? Angular will also create an spec.ts file that is basically used for performing tests of the component, okay? But in this Hello World application, we are of course not going to create a test for the application, so it is not necessary to modify nothing in this file, okay? We will just modify the message that Angular sets in the main view of the component, and we will introduce a new style for modifying the style of the application. So now, if I when this process finished, I will see here in my folder a new folder that contains the project. The name of the folder is of course the name of the project, and as you can see here, going to the source part of the application and going to the application folder, we can see the main module that Angular uses in this application, and also the files of the main component, okay? If we go here, we can see how Angular is rendering the welcome message, and we can see how this title property is defined here in the logic of the application. So if this works, in the template Angular should show welcome to application, welcome to app, as we can see here, okay? So let's see if Angular has finished. You can see how the project has been created. So I enter here in the folder Angular has created, and here if I execute ng serve, Angular will automatically build the application and serve the application in this localhost 4200 port. Okay, so now when the application is finally launched, I will be able to open a browser and to go to localhost 4200, and as you can see here, I see the application Angular has deployed for me, okay? So what I'm going to do now is to basically change here the title. So I'm going to put here my new application, and if I save the file, you can see here how Angular has automatically compiled, rebuilt, and relaunched the application. And when going to my application, you can see how Angular has modified here this title. Okay. The second thing I'm going to do is to include here in the template a new class for this tag. So we have put here my cool header. I can define now a class in my CSS file of the component that you can see now is of course empty, and if I put here color, for instance color red, of course this CSS style should be applied to my title. I have to do nothing to relaunch the application, and as you can see here, it is automatically rebuilt and relaunched by Angular. Okay, so now we have our first Angular application up and running, so we can say that we have performed the objectives of this video. See you in the next video. Bye.